and whoever can make it who is looking on the streaming. And the first piece I will play is the Harp Concerto by Handel. And it actually belongs to the 6 organ concertos, opera 4 for organ. They can be played on the organ and harpsichord. However, it was initially intended for the harp. They were played in the as interludes to the Oratorio Alexander's Feast performed at Covent Garden. And the harp at the time was very different. It was a triple harp, and it had 3 rows of strings. The 2 outer rows were parallel and corresponded to the white keys on the piano, and the middle row was slightly shifted so that you could reach with the fingers inside, and it corresponded to what could be the black keys of the piano. So it was very different, but I will play it today on the concert harp.
Thank you.
Sospiro, or A Sigh, by Liszt. It is the third concert study for piano, and like all concert studies, or like all studies, there are a few techniques that are developed. So in this case, there is a layer of arpeggios in which the melody floats on top, alternated between the hands. And the transcription for harp was made by the harpist Henriette Renié, and she was a very famous harpist and composer. And like some transcriptions, obviously there are some things that had to be adapted, such as the cadenzas, but also the addition of harmonics, which are very beautiful on the harp. And I think this transcription particularly suits the harp.
Thank you.
Marescotti. He's not so well known as a composer to the wider public as he is to the musicians, but he won the Grand Prix in Geneva after Arturo Benedetti Michelangeli commissioned a piece for piano, and then they won with his performance. And he lived all through the 1900s, so I think he embeds a few different styles, and at one point, there's quite a dense writing, but at one point there's a moment that is almost like a free cadenza, and I hear some impressionism inside as well. harpist in the room, but for the non-harpist, I thought to explain briefly about the harp. There are 47 strings on the concert harp, 7 pedals, and 3 steps in each pedal, and I'll explain what they do. So, if all the pedals are natural, there's 1 pedal for each note, the strings correspond exactly to the white keys on the piano. Now, they can transform, and according to where the pedal is, the string can change sound. And that was the same string. So, the amazing thing about the harp is, thanks to this system, we can create fantastic glissandi that you all know, that you've heard in movies, and that everyone is just amazed by. But on the other hand, it's also very, very complex to have all the pedals in mind, all the combinations that you change as you play. Now, I hope you won't all look at my feet right now as I start the new piece, but it's the unique thing, I think, about the harp is this system that allows for so many different combinations. So, the next piece in the program is the Sicilienne variée by Jean-Michel Damase. The Siciliana is a traditional dance in a compound meter, generally 6/8, and it's quite slow. And the composer wrote it in the form of a theme and variation. So you will hear the theme repeated multiple times using different techniques on the harp. So it could be arpeggios, glissandi, harmonics. And the unique thing about this piece is that there is no clear cut between each variation. They all flow into one another, which I think is beautiful. And the composer was the son of Micheline Kahn, a very famous harpist at the time, who worked with lots of composers like Caplet, Ravel, Fauré, and so thanks to that, the composer composed lots and lots for the harp, solo and chamber music. Thank you. Dance No. 1 from the opera La Vida Breve. The opera was originally a short opera, 1 hour long approximately, and it was meant to be for puppets. I think that's what you call it in English, marionette. And the composer transcribed the Spanish Dance No. 1, which is part of the second act, for piano. And Marcel Grandjany, very famous harpist as well, he did the transcription for harp, inspired by the piano one. And the Falla belonged to the Spanish nationalist movement and music. And so you will hear a lot of national Spanish influence, maybe some flamenco, and it's a quite dynamic piece. Thank you.